How's it going, everybody? I'm Smokecover13 and welcome back to another vlog. Not just any vlog, another NASCAR vlog. We got our boy Thomas right here.
Hey, what's up?
So you know what that means with the camera going to another NASCAR race. And it's 2022.
It's the big one.
It's the big one.
The big one.
We are back! All right, so we're in Darlington right now, going to the hotel room for the first night. Then tomorrow we're gonna get up, get to Florida. It's about 5 more hours at least. Pretty nice. What do you think?
Just can't wait for tomorrow, man.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. So how's your trip up here?
Wow.
Wow.
Holy shit, a microwave. Who knows those came in hotels? The past year did it.
Yeah.
Trip's already better than the others.
Yeah, like the other hotel we got when we came to Darlington, this is the, like, we're actually in Darlington, so, but the hotel that we got in Rockingham did not have a microwave. We end up buying food
at a gas station.
At a gas station that used a microwave, but we ended up forgetting that there is
use the coffee maker to make my ramen.
Yeah, there was no microwave. And check this out. Look at this picture right here. Oh, wow.
I didn't
even
know that.
Yo, check that out. That is cool. Dale Jr., Kurt Busch, Kasey Kahne, Jimmy Johnson, Brian Vickers, Jeff Burton, Harvick, and Truex. That is a really cool picture right there. I like that.
Meanwhile, leave
the
shower running?
Sure.
Bathroom's alright.
Bathroom looks pretty nice. I like it. Man, look at this. We got mouthwash for this? Huh. Never seen that. Hmm. What if it tastes like Neutrogena?
I don't know what to say to that. I think that's Myrtle Beach.
That has to
be. Because I've been there thousands of times.
Has to be. Yo, let's go to Cracker Barrel. It closes at 9. It's like 8:58.
Oh yeah, man. I mean, it's Cracker Barrel, man. It's all about hospitality, man. I mean, come in there. I mean, who cares what late, man? I mean, they can just serve us.
Yeah, they can still serve us.
If not, then I mean,
even if we get there at 8:59, they'll still serve us.
And guess what? If they won't serve us, we'll just go there for morning for breakfast.
All right, so we just got back to the hotel room. We just got something to eat, and as you can see, my mess right there. We went by Taco Bell. Then. When I was talking to Thomas for a little bit, he brought his Xbox, and come to find out, so he's got the Xbox right here, it's already on, but come to find out, the way how he plugged it in, he plugged it in through the microwave, you see? See the cord and everything, but hey, as long as the Xbox works. But yeah, we're gonna get up early in the morning, the checkout time is not till 12 o'clock. So we're going to check out, get up early in the morning, go find something to eat in the morning, get some good breakfast. Take about 5 more hours to get to Daytona Beach. Good night, everyone. I will see y'all tomorrow morning. We're at the pilot station getting more gas and went inside a pilot station and I discovered something that I'm truly happy I ended up getting for myself. Got a nice looking Bud Light hat. So I always wanted to get a good Bud Light hat. And this guy over here ends up getting a Natural Light hat. Got a big cup of coffee right there.
He's
And since I picked the driver to at least win the Daytona 500, Ryan Blaney, I think Ryan Blaney is gonna get it.
Fastest in second practice.
That's good then. So we got how many hours to get there? Like how many
about
miles?
Four.
About 4 more hours.
We'll get there about 6 o'clock on the dot.
Yeah, all right, so, yeah. 6 o'clock, the traffic, we only had to deal with rain just a little bit. Traffic is not really that bad. Daytona International.
We're about 400 miles away, and we're on the same road for 300 of it. So.
Yeah. So yeah, we got a bit of ways to go. There's actually one place that me and Thomas been wanting to visit for a pretty long time, and it's right there.
You want me to say it?
Yeah.
Buc-ee's!
Yeah, we always wanted to go to a Buc-ee's so bad, because, like, there's no Buc-ee's in Virginia.
I thought they were only in Texas, like.
Yeah, like, I thought they was only in Texas, but I remember there were some in, like Georgia and all them, and I was like, well, Florida's got to have one. And then, look at that, there's one right there. So, if I can do it, but there it is. So yeah, we're gonna go to Buc-ee's and check it out. And, you know, see what we can find.
842.
Dude, this place is cool. It is massive too. Like, holy moly, this place is huge. This place is amazing. It's like humongous. This is the biggest like gas station, store, or whatever I ever been to.
The way time flies when we're close to the end. Now I'm thinking I spent my life learning to fly despite a constant descent. I was born to fly.
That out. We are in Daytona.
See, it's Florida. I ain't trying to get hemmed up.
Hey, first time going to Daytona. Let's go.
He's recording it.
I know I've been to so many races in my time, but this is different.
No, I'm just
this takes the cake. Charlotte, Nashville, Martinsville, Richmond, Bristol. In my opinion, this track is different. This track hits different. All right, so we're inside the racetrack right now. We just got our ticket scanned. About to go on the escalators. Hey, what was that game that SpongeBob played? Shoots and Ladders? Was it like, no.
Something escalators.
Eels and Escalators. Eels and Escalators. Going up. Wow, this is actually really nice because even though it's huge, but wow, it's incredible. Wow. What do you think?
I like it.
It's pretty nice.
I like Brady's car.
Look at all these cool helmets I got. Really nice. That's a Dale Jr. helmet. Another Exalta helmet. Really cool. Got Exalta all over on the floor. Nice, got the 2488 and another 24. It's actually really cool. I gotta check the back of it, see if it's got the skeleton symbol. Oh yes, it does. Everybody knows that. That's a Dale Jr. helmet right there. All right, so we walked like a mile to get up here at the very top, but holy moly, this is really cool. Thomas is pretty impressed right now about the track.
I like it a whole lot.
And also the stands are pretty nice. It looks pretty good. Everybody, they're pretty much revving their engine. But I gotta say, big screen right there so you can see what's going on around the track. We can see the turns from up here really good.
Just got the backstroke.
You could barely see the backstretch. I mean, I can at least see it back there. It's up here. It's a little windy up here since we're, you know, high up here. Ready for the cars to go around in the oval. And so I can get it on footage for you guys.
Welcome to the World Seraph Racing. Tonight we decide who will indeed lead the green flag on Sunday for the 64th running on today's 1500. Exalta provides a range of performance and transportation coatings for manufacturers of white and commercial vehicles. The refinisher market. For your partner and sponsor, Daytona International Speedway. We know it's the Geico restart zone. It could be the Duke at Daytona. A one quick reminder, Toyota injector is stacked with great items as well. Toyota, great founding partner of Daytona International Raceway's brand new day at the track. And on behalf of Toyota, we'd like to wish you good luck to all the drivers today and remind all our fans that from the race day to bring back home.
Right now.
first.
Come on alone, head for the mountains of bush beer. Head for the mountains, it's cold and it's smooth, and it's waiting for you. Come on, head for the mountains of blue.
Well, there's all the Hendrick cars right there before they go back to qualifying for the final 10 spots real quick. But, man, that image right there is amazing.
Alright, Bowman's got the pole right now. Larson's out right now. He's on his lap. Alright, he's coming right now. And Larson will get. He got the pole. He got the pole. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Oh well. I mean, we'll probably start P2. Yeah, he'll probably be P2 or P3 at least. So we'll find out. All right, William Byron is coming. William Byron is coming, and he's got. He got P3. We've started P2, baby. Let's go. We got P2. Starting on the front row with Kyle Larson. Let's go. I don't know who's going to win the Daytona 500, so we'll find out this Sunday, baby. Let's go.
So we're finally in the hotel room. Got something to eat. Trying Wingstop for the first time. And pretty good wings. Tomorrow, going to go to the flea market and go to the fan zone. Try to see if I can get Denny Hamlin's autograph. The duels are tomorrow, so looking forward to it and see who's going to get into the Daytona 500. I think everybody's going to be careful in that race because they only got like one car, maybe some of them got two back, maybe some of them got backups, I don't know, but yeah, it's going to be pretty cool.
Well, there's the beach. Isn't it beautiful? Amazing outside. But kind of looks like it's gonna rain at any minute, but they're not supposed to call any rain, but looks good outside.
All right, so we're at the Daytona flea market. Looks huge, looks pretty big. Ready to see what they got.
Oh wow, it's very much people here actually, so looks pretty cool. A little warm outside, so that's gonna be that's actually good because down in Virginia it's so cold, but down here it feels amazing. So gonna see what we can find, and hopefully we can find some diecast or something. I know there's like a game store here I want to check out, but hopefully we find something good. Yo, you're talking about NASCAR heaven. Look at all this stuff. It's awesome, dude. Look at all these cool shirts, and oh my lord, dude, they got so much stuff. I actually got the Josh Berry shirt I wanted. Dude, they are Dale Seniors. Oh, wow. Holy moly. Look at all this good stuff. Like, look at that. That is cool. Yeah. I do like the Alex Bowman one. That car's cool. There's the Dale Jr. Bristol. I like that Wendell Scott shirt right there. And look at all these really nice looking elites, like especially the Dale Jr. Especially, I love that three doors down car. It's cool. It's really cool. A couple Dale Sr. ones right here. Yeah. That's some cool stuff. That's a pit hat from Larson. Check out this Richard Petty collection. There's a signed Kyle Busch car right there.
Yeah, is that something?
Look at all the cool sheet metal. And they got gas cans over there. Love that nice looking color chrome Keselowski. And check this out. Nice looking die cast right there. Championship shirt. Got some more sheet metal over here. Got some rims, tires. And check this out. These are like Coca-Cola frames you put in your drink machines. Really nice. That's Tony Stewart. And you got a Joey Logano. Alright, so we just left the flea market. And I got some cool stuff. Right now we're actually going to head to Walmart. We're actually in the Walmart parking lot right now. And got to get a couple things. Get some drinks in. Before we head to the track, we're going to get something to eat. And I always want to go to Cheddar's.
And
go to Tolerantic and see what that place is like. And also I did get some fan zone passes for the duels and try to see if I can go meet Denny Hamlin. And because I brought the Martinsville win and get that signed, I'm just ready for the duels because I'm hoping Bowman can win one of them, win it in his race, and Ryan Blaney, so both of us can be happy. Just hoping things will go well tonight for them, and hopefully everybody will be safe tonight because, you know, anything can happen in this race. Alrighty, we're finally at Cheddar's right now. Really excited to try this place out. I'm stuffed. What do you think?
It was delicious.
Food was great. I loved it. We gotta find another Cheddar's on the way. Really good food.
We gotta go back to Bucky's.
Yeah, we gotta go back to Bucky's too. Alright, we are at the racetrack. About to go into the fan zone and try to see if I can get this diecast signed by the one and only Denny Hamlin. Well, inside the racetrack right now, he's trying to get some Ryan Blaney autographs.
And Kyle Larson.
And Larson. It's pretty nice inside. A lot of campers, RVs. Pretty nice. And surprisingly on like the banking, seeing the banking on the inside is unbelievable. Yo, Ben Rhodes! Got Ben Rhodes on this hat. Pretty good looking signature. All right, we are finally inside the racetrack for the fan zone. It's quite nice in here. I think it's worth it because I just met Ben Rhodes as well. And he, you know, he just walked out and I saw BJ McLeod walk too. So he's gonna be around here somewhere. Check out like all the venues you got around this area. Like look at the Busch Light stands, got some food. Got the good old delicious Budweiser Bistro. You know me, I love Budweiser.
See that happening based on the fact that you've got a brand new kind of reconstituted race team to play with this year, huh?
Yeah, that's everything's new. I mean, I look back, NASCAR's been quite 71 years.
Yeah.
And everything we've done in the past, we started with a strictly stock car. And then kept getting different. They wound up with the cars that we had last year. This year we're throwing away everything we've ever done. Everything we thought we knew is behind us. So everything's new. I guess that guy didn't want to hear me talk.
We'll be right back.
just went through the fan experience. It was cool, really cool. Actually gonna come back here Sunday. I think it was worth it. Tom has had a good time. And pretty cool seeing Eric and Joey Logano. If you can hear me over AC/DC music. I think it was worth it. I think it was absolutely worth going inside the track. Hopefully he does pretty good. I think he's handling himself pretty well. You?
I don't like heights.
Yeah, he doesn't like heights at all. Like, we are really high up. Isn't that crazy? And the good thing is about this, you can actually see the back stretch, which I'm really happy I can, because where we were sitting during qualifying, we couldn't see anything.
Fastest, the next one would walk into the Daytona 500, and that would be Kaz Rala. So Lumbo is standing by with one of those three drivers on the grid, JJ Elliott. Monica.
It is crowded down here on the grid. Everybody's ready to get out there and race his way in to the Daytona 500.
Oh, well, JJ Yeelys as their fate lays in where they finish here tonight.
Thank you. stuck inside my brain. Something's always over. Feels like the game's come true. Stay center, we'll get to the second spot. Not to the back bumper. Brad Keselowski, the race leader. He continues to maintain the top spot. Here's Prisco to the outside of Cedric for second.
They race their way back to the top. Checkers in the air, across the line, Brad Keselowski wins. Last lap pass on J.J. Healy, and he is in the Great American Race. What an incredible comeback from Kaz Grala. He had that pit road speeding penalty on lap 36, and he's able to recover and make a last lap pass to get in the 500.
And that's what it's about. He dug deep. He was able to qualify for the Great American Race. But how about Brad Keselowski steps into an ownership role of this RFK Racing number 6.
To the bottom, it is Alex Bowman, race leader, out front.
Lap one done here in duel number two. It took Eric a little while to get caught up and wound up, but now he's going to get blown away.
Experiences Harrison Burton tucked right up underneath the back bumper there on the outside lane, trying to shove Joey Logano to the lead. He's successful.
Oh, what in the world? Somebody spun.
Gamble was trying to slow down the side. Immediately damaged that FedEx Toyota Camry, but he's in the grass right now.
Denny Hamlin
now will try to make his pit stop, but a costly mistake for Denny Hamlin trying to get on pit road.
Kyle Busch sliding into his pit stop, and he was very quick, and he was able to get off pit road first, picked up quite a few spots, and all the Toyotas coming out.
Slower car, white flag is in the air. Harvick is the one that gets lapped.
It's official and it's over. Chris Buescher, he has won duel number two.
The last duel was crazy because Logano tried to block. Chris Buescher was there and carnage happened with Joey Logano hitting the wall. So
rightfully did.
Yeah, so it, I don't know. I don't know, like, it wasn't, I mean, it was the final lap, so. You're gonna,
only RFK car that did it too.
Yeah, and speaking about RFK, Keselowski ends up winning the first duel, and all of a sudden, Chris Buescher ends up winning the second duel. So RFK swept the duels today, so that was really cool. All right, now it's gonna get something to eat and go to wherever we're going to find something to eat. I don't know. Well, we're finally at the hotel, and we ended up winning. We ended up going to this pizza place called Stoner's Pizza Joint. So, sounds cool and reasonable. Check out their pizza. Gonna get up tomorrow and go to the beach for a little bit, and before we head back to the racetrack for the truck race. Look at how beautiful the ocean is. Hey Thomas, who invented the ocean?
GMC Instructional 58.
Walked on the beach for a little bit. Love the feeling of the water, the ocean. Feels great. Cold, but feels great. I haven't been on the beach in a good while. I'd say about 10 years at least. It was, it's actually beautiful here. Really beautiful. What's up, dudes? All right, so we're about to leave and go get something to eat. Gonna check out this place called Bonefish Grill. Go to the racetrack and wait till the truck race starts tonight. I'm looking forward for this truck race because it's, I haven't been to many of the truck races, but especially since this is Daytona, truck racing is always amazing, and it's gonna be a wild race tonight. All right, so we went to this mall and got some pretty good stores in there, and then went to F.Y.E., found a good amount of stuff I wanted, and then there's this game store in there that I was really interested, and then I came across something that I think is really cool. This MX game, and guess who's on the front cover? Jamie Little is on the cover. And since she does broadcasting, you know, interviews and all that kind of stuff for NASCAR, I'm going to see if I can take this game over there and see if I can get it signed by her. Hopefully it can work. I'll just try to see if I can find her in the infield or something, see if I can get it signed by Jamie Little. Just about to probably go over there, go to the racetrack in a little bit, and see what we can do and find something to do before the truck race starts. All right, so I walk in back into the infield. I ended up getting more passes, trying to see if I can get anyone to sign this car or meet some of the drivers inside. We'll see how this goes. Thank you, Eric. Thanks so much, man. Hey, you got it, man. You got an autograph. Let's go. Oh, yeah, there we go. I'm like, yeah, that's true. There you go. Thank you, Harrison. Get a picture like Stanson falling out in a drought. No flow rain was I'm falling down. See that famous. Thank you so much. My mode was kind of lounge. Didn't know which way to turn. Flow was cool, but I still felt burned. Energy up, you can feel my surge. I'm gonna kill everything. Thank you, Chris. That's the code around this for you, man.
What up, boys? Chair gate. Smoke carbon. We're doing it big. Daytona, baby.
Oh, hell yeah, man. Let's go.
Put that on the vlog.
Let's go. Thanks, Ryan. But I know I don't blame everything that I say. Man, I see the deflate. Let me elevate. Thanks, man. Crank. Have you looking on the plane? My boy got his diecast signed. Let's go. Thanks so much, man. Good luck. We just met a lot of drivers today, and I still didn't get Denny Hamlin's autograph for the diecast, but I tell you what, I got a lot of them. I even
tatted up.
Yeah, we even met Blaney. I even met Bowman. I mean, we both met Blaney and Bowman, so.
I got one of my diecast signs.
Yeah, he got his diecast signed, and we're coming back in here Sunday. Trying this again so I can get that Hamlin car signed. He did get one of his Blaney car signed, but he's got another one he wants to get signed. Incredible experience I'm enjoying right here. But now it's about time, getting close to the truck race, so we're gonna head up and go to the stands and watch the truck race. All right, on to the truck race we go. I don't know who's gonna win it. I don't know, I kind of want to see Lawless win it, or I don't know, maybe Haley Deegan will get it, or Carson Hosevar might get it. We will find out, or hell, Granny Finger is in this, so we'll see who's gonna win it. So we got TJ over here.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, awesome dude. It's really cool, man, to finally meet you.
Mm-hmm.
And experience Daytona for the first time, just like us too. Having a great time so far, electrifying. And where are y'all sitting at?
Section 489.
That's, we sat at 480 yesterday, I think. So
okay.
477 at least.
Okay, nice.
It was right here, actually.
Oh, nice.
But we're about to go to 466, I think.
Oh, okay, I gotcha.
Yeah, man, have a great time.
Yeah, you too.
Enjoy the race and everything. And here's for a picture.
Oh, okay.
Race fans, the 2022 season for the Truck Series is underway here in Daytona.
Side of the racetrack, they're stacked up double wide, halfway down the Daytona Superstretch. The inside line starts to advance for a moment, but here comes the outside. Tyler Ankrum with a ton of help now, up to second.
Tyler Ankrum leading that outside lane, pulls up alongside John Hunter Nemechek in a side-by-side race to the second spot. Ankrum has drafting help from Corey Heim. Top five is a
Jeske right at the bottom of the racetrack. He's got the inside lane right on the tailgate. Ty Majeski will lead.
I'm both of those KB and Toyotas complaining of loose conditions, but here is Ty Majeski. Let's follow that stop for that Toyota. It looks like it's going to be fuel. The race car is doing
side 10 rows deep.
Three and four, John Hunter Nemechek got very loose on the bottom of the racetrack. That allowed Friesen to inch up alongside. Friesen's still there. Friesen's getting a huge jump from Majeski. Stuart Friesen to the lead in Daytona.
White checkered flag, the end of stage number two. Side by side to the stripe. Who's going to win the stage? And it's
way of trucks to move up and give him a run.
Grayson's got a little bit of momentum up there. He powers to the outside of Jesse Little. Little by little, will overhaul him. Tries to get that outside line rolling as they work off turn two.
That outside line has got three trucks to corner, now six, but it's still not enough. They're way outnumbered. More trucks if they want to propel themselves to the lead.
That outside lane forming up just inside of the top 10. The first eight or so trucks in line huddled up against the bottom of the racetrack off turn four. Right by Colby Howard.
Off turn number four, back to the line. 49 laps to go. Colby Howard enjoying the view right now at the front of the field.
Wildly to the bottom as he heads for Mike Bagley.
Come to a rest midway down the Daytona Superstretch. Solo truck incident. Jack Wood now a lot of damage on his truck as he is now coasted to a halt, and safety crews now immediately on the scene to tend to him and that truck.
Oh!
Christian Eckes, yeah. Top three under caution.
Under caution awesome. For the four.
Down to double wide formation. They stack it up from second on back off the end of the backstretch.
It would be Smith
leading that outside lane and has drafting help.
Move began with Austin Hill. Smith will jump up in front of Austin Hill. It's down to double wide formation. They stack it up from second on back off the end of the backstretch.
It would be Smith
leading that outside lane and has drafting help from Austin Hill along with Chandler Smith.
Oh, there's
inside
a wreck.
Of the racetrack. John Hunter Neiman checked
the
race.
Oh, my goodness. He saved it! No, never mind. Never mind, they're ready.
One of those trucks involved. Three others become collected, including Chris White, who got spinning out. Place truck also will shift to the outside lane with John Hunter Nemechek.
Boy, John Hunter Nemechek, itchy and ready to go to the front.
The drivers will come around, they'll get the green flag, they'll come around and get the white flag, which will be the last lap of the race, and then the checkered flag. If what happens just a moment ago occurs again, where there's a wreck on the racetrack in between...
Well, they just say the race is not official yet,
that
so
is what we are being told
this race
at
ain't
this
over
moment.
Yet.
Still
just
the
yet.
Is going
so,
on, and they, as Jeff Stringer, the little race another mentioned a few moments ago, practically the entire field
I'm
wiped
going with the
out
final
in
lap
this
as well,
crash.
Because this...
It all depends on when the moment of caution was displayed.
We got some more race footage
starter
for you guys.
Put the yellow flag out.
Start zone overtime attempt number one underway here in Daytona. Here at Daytona, this time it's overtime.
Smith not only has drafting help, he's got shoving help. Parker Klugerman is trying to push Zane Smith to the lead. He'll do it. Smith goes to the lead, but Smith will cross over and leave Klugerman high and dry at three.
And Klugerman will fade outside of the top three as Zane Smith goes to the point. Christian Eckes in second. Ben Rhodes in third. Lined up single file.
Zane Smith racing back to the white flag. Here they come to the trial. A little further back, three wide, top four, nose to top.
Zane Smith out front when the caution flag came out for a crash exiting the trial.
Wow, Zane Smith won.
Spun all the way down towards the inside of turn number one as safety trucks pull onto the speedway. The caution is out, and Zane Smith has won the next Era Energy 250 at Daytona International Speedway.
And we'll have to wait now to see who actually will be scored second on back. It may very well be Christian.
Top drivers in just
well,
a minute. Zane Smith
ends up winning the race.
Into the F-150. That was, he's going to take it to Ruoff Mortgage Victory Lane. Let's go down and hear from the driver
not
who finished
be
third, Tanner
the
Gray.
Lap, but there was, and the caution
Tanner
came
Gray
out, and Zane Smith ends up winning.
Out of his black
so,
automobile.
What do you think of the race?
Looking up at the scoring column.
That was awesome.
The third
I mean, I, that was my pick right here, Zane Smith. I mean, what are the odds? But that's cool. From our Motorsports Center. The Love Travel Stops car. How about that?
On the bottom all night.
I think they found the good luck charm, so
yeah,
they run that scheme more often.
It was like we
yeah, it was an exciting race. I thought it was really good. That was one of the biggest crashes I've ever seen in a NASCAR race that I remember.
Black tire on board here at Daytona.
Wow, what a show. What a show.
Death Lippard sucks.
That is not true. He's getting it from Joe Dirt. All right, the ARCA race is about to start in a little bit. We're walking to our seats right now. And then after the ARCA race, the Xfinity race starts at like 5 o'clock. But for the Xfinity race, I do got Josh Berry or Justin Allgaier to win that race.
Here, the pace truck will head down the pit lane and then it'll turn them loose. 80 laps, 200 miles, ARCA Menard Series. Coming down for the initial green, Corey Heim to the 20, the pole sitter brings him on up through the gears, and the 2022 season is underway for the ARCA Menard Series.
Will put us under the caution flag. Wow. And as we continue to just monitor what's going on all the way around the racetrack, 50 laps complete under caution.
Chase tries to keep up on the inside lane.
On the outside lane. He's going to...
Chase, outside lane's got nothing going right now. Here comes Corey.
cars torn to pieces.
They stay under the green flag. Here they come, racing back to the checkered flag. It's in the air. Torrey Heim is going to go back to back here at Daytona. The checkered flag.
Here this afternoon, started up front, finished up front, and here he is, race fans, as he comes by you live here at Daytona style, the winner of today's Lucas Oil 200, driven by General Tire, the young talent, Torrey Heim.
Torrey Heim now joining the list of drivers like Bobby Gerhardt and Grant Enfinger as the only
Torrey Heim goes back to back. But that was a really hard hit for the 18 of Drew Dollar. Like, he really hit the outside wall pretty hard. And, yeah, that was a head-on hit. And, Toby's all right, but, geez, that was a hard hit. Congratulations for Torrey Heim for winning and going back-to-back. And about 1 hour, the Xfinity race is about to start. And I'm really excited for that one.
Down to pole position in a brand new car for this season. He is your NASCAR Xfinity Series defending champion in the AG1 Athletic Green Chevrolet from Kannapolis, North Carolina, Daniel
to a Daytona race. I get a chance to experience it with my kids. And so my daughter Skylar, my son Elijah, we're here to support Jesse, our driver, and cheer.
Famous words in motorsports. Please welcome Florida Cattleman and past president of National Cattlemen's Beef Association, Marty Smith.
On behalf of America's farmers and ranchers who work hard every day to produce beef for your dinner, it's my privilege to announce, drivers, start your engines.
Side in turn number three, that'll open the door for JP Fern about the challenge for the second spot.
Eric will drift up the racetrack, ride right in the middle of the racing surface. Now he'll snap it back to the bottom. Lap number one goes in the books. The champion.
Austin Hill, but Hill with the block, and he will maintain the lead. Coming across the line, 10 down, Austin Hill.
Do indeed, it's Hill down. Both lanes, he'll switch to the bottom at the start and finish the line.
Stage number two to get around Noah Gregson. I do not know how they did not wreck.
But luckily he saved it. And Daniel Henry ends up winning stage two.
A great job.
So we got one more stage to go. This race is just getting started.
Let's see if that will trigger everybody else to make their way to pit road. They will.
Oh, there they go.
They come up off of turn number four, jamming on the brakes. Begin to slide. It's Sam Mayer who's going to back his way towards it. We'll be right back.
leading the outside lane. Everybody in double wide formation. Now Austin Hill will change lanes. He'll jump up in front of Grayson. And now he'll pull down and drop the AJ Allmendinger car. Austin Hill all by himself in the front of the field. They go side by side for second. AJ Allmendinger to the inside of Noah Grayson. Then it's Ty Gibbs inside of Ryan Castle.
And NASCAR has alerted us this restart is under review.
Oh!
A scary, scary crash. Austin Hill, though, the race winner, doing donuts on the front straightaway. He is your race winner in the Beef It's What's for Dinner 300 tonight here at Daytona.
So we're back in the car after the Xfinity race, and that was a wild finish. Austin Hill ends up winning, but it's crazy how Maya Snyder ends up flipping on the backstretch and also hits the cat's finch. And thank God she's okay. Like, thank God, because it was a wild ride for him, and the car is destroyed. It's total. I'm just glad he's safe. Very terrifying crash. This is the first time I've ever seen a car flip, like, at a race. I'm just glad he's okay. Tomorrow's the big day. Tomorrow is the Daytona 500. See who's gonna win the Great American Race. And, tomorrow I'm also going to the fan zone pretty early, so I can try and get this diecast signed. So, wish me luck. And I will see y'all tomorrow. So after the Xfinity race, we went to Walmart, and what they got at Walmart is Michael Waltrip's brewing beer, and it's a two-time checkered pass coconut India Pale Ale, and I never tried it. Thomas is going to try it as well, and really interested on what two-time Daytona 500 winner has in stall. So we're going to try it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Not bad.
It's not bad.
It to be honest, it's got like a IPA, just like a hint of coconut on the back end.
It tastes like a regular, yeah, kind of tastes like a regular IPA, and it's got like a peach vibe to it, like a little peach vibe. So, not too bad.
Not worth $10.
No, it's not worth $10 in my opinion. But not too bad.
How much alcohol is in this?
6.2. So not bad. I think he's got different flavors out there. I think that's gonna be better than this. Or maybe worse. I don't know. I haven't tried them. What would you rate this? I give it at least a 6. So if we ever find any more of these, probably pick them up and have them as like a collector's item. But kudos to Michael Walter. Big day for racing. Daytona 500s today. Been wanting to go to this race for 20 some years, and it's finally happening and a dream becoming a reality. Happy birthday to this guy. And I will see y'all at Daytona. Until I fade away, why give up? Why give in? It's not enough. Daytona grass. Let's go.
With multiple championships and an even smaller list with the different crew chiefs and different organizations.
Let's try it. Wow, this is cool. That is awesome. Feel the safer barrier, then you got the wall right here. On the track.
Talk about it being a team sport. It's going to be the driver's responsibility here in Little League. But before that, it's going to be the pit crew's opportunity to show. Ty Larson has their number one pit stall. Will that make a difference, baby?
This is the money stop. Who determined the championship? Last set of fresh Goodyear tires. The crew on the right side. Old tires up, new tires up.
Let's go.
What if I get a cab? This is car.
Let's do it.
Oh. Shout out to Old Dog too.
Yeah, shout out to Old Dog. We are inside the racetrack and this is amazing. Like, I really want to come back here.
Best fan experience so far.
Yeah, best fan experience so far. Love it. It's different. It makes you feel like at home. And being a big NASCAR fan like us, it's home.
It feels like we're at South Boston Speedway, man. It's just the atmosphere. It's just, like you said, it's a home vibe.
Yeah, it feels amazing.
Laid back, not corporate.
Yeah, it feels amazing. Yeah, like, it's pretty cool because, like, with the racing and all that, I don't know, I'm just waiting for the Daytona 500 to get started, just to witness some history. So it's pretty cool.
Well, he literally has to go. I mean, he has to be on the grid.
Hey, you guys,
what's up, man?
Yeah.
That's the view. We are so high up, man. Like, we're at the highest peak of this track.
I'm a little nervous, but fears are something that's meant to overcome.
That's true. So, hopefully. Let's go, Bowman.
You got much choice now, anybody.
Let's go, Bowman. Or Larson.
Side is Yaley in turns three and four.
Aurora makes the pass on Yaley, who had no drafting partner. And Cavs Bravo will race in the Daytona 500. Wow.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, signals that star-spangled banner yet away, o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Let's hear it for Trace Atkins' performance of our national anthem along with the United States Air Force Thunderbirds for today's flyover.
And now, race fans, here to say the most famous words in motorsports, please welcome Pro Football Hall of Famer, Heisman Trophy winner, and Fox NFL analyst, Charles Woodson.
Let's go.
Daytona, are you ready?
Woo! Yeah!
Drivers, start your engines!
That's how you do it.
Yeah!
Shit, woo, man, Charles was getting people hyped since college.
Again,
yeah.
All right.
Woo!
Point. He's got me being the Johnny right behind him.
500 champion, Indianapolis 500 champion. He's a driver that's having to learn on the fly. That team has struggled with engine issues and ran the spring vacation race.
Here towards towards the end of stage number one. But here is how the top 10 finished at the end of stage number one. Martin Truex Jr. again getting the stage one win. Brad Keselowski, Todd Gilliland, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. and...
here in Daytona to the attention of his crew to see if they can get that sorted out. There's a 27 of Jacques Villeneuve. He was directly behind the 8 of Tyler Reddick at the time of the incident. But we do know several of the contenders taken out in this one, including Tyler Reddick in the 8. There's Joey Logano in the 22. And heavy damage for the driver who won both stages here today.
By a car that's not moving at all in front of Steve Post.
See, it's Tyler Reddick's car, and I'm not sure what the problem is. The car will not roll. That's why they had to push it behind the generator.
He's getting pulled off of pit road. The race leader is Brad Keselowski. Pit road is now open. The green light at the entrance of pit lane. A critical late race pit stop for these NASCAR Cup Series teams and what could decide their position to be able to win today's Daytona 500. Brad Keselowski pulls off the banking. He's headed for pit road.
Pace car peels off. 41 laps to go here in Daytona. They're going to the Geico restart zone. It's Austin Cindric and Bill Wallace on the front row. We're back to the main.
So far today, pushing others to the lead. Keselowski down, and maybe it was too super extreme.
Chris Buescher trying to go underneath him, Bubba, through a major bump. Outside lane, though, begins to form up again.
Eric Almirola completes the top five. What a run.
comes. A photo finish at the line, but Austin Cindric
looks at the Great American Race and the Harley J. Earl Trophy. He celebrates here on the front straightaway in Daytona, now a champion of the Daytona 500.
That was the end of the race. The race was really good. Crazy that Harrison Burton flipped over. I wasn't expecting that. Luckily, he's okay. Bowman got into the wreck, unfortunately. But this was actually a really good Daytona 500 race. Since Austin Cindric got it, first career win too. I really wanted Blaney to win it, but
we had a shot at going to victory lane.
I mean, at least he got a top five. At least a Penske car won.
That's fun. Almost had it. A great Daytona 500.
Happy birthday to this man right here. He's bummed out since Blaney didn't get it. But we got Martinsville, baby. We got Martinsville. That is the end for the Daytona 500 vlog. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. Also subscribe for more if you want more NASCAR vlogs. We had a hell of a trip during Daytona. I love it here. Cannot wait to come back here for sure.
Everything that that means.
Thank y'all so much. Thank you all so much for the support. And thank y'all for needing me. And it's incredible how much experience. And how fun this place
just
is.
Just a nose, and he's love missing a right front y'all. Fender.
Remember,
I mean, how did you do that? You almost had a shot with a car that I know wasn't 100.
Sky.